kind of rotating this pocket watch. I don't know why. Hello everyone, my name is Mike and welcome back to the Order 1886. In the last video we finished off chapter 5, Agamemnon Rising, and at the end of the chapter the ship was blown up and crashed down to the ground. So now we're going to jump in and see what's happened to Lord Galahad. I mean, he must have survived it because the game's not over yet, so let's jump into this, chapter 6. Oh, there we go, triangle. Got any more medicine left? I mean, if ever in doubt, just take some potion, innit? Always seems to fix any illness, any pain. Get you on your feet. So this is chapter 6, In the Darkest Hour. It's a pretty big mess right here. We're separated from the rest of the knights. Let's see where we can go. There's a path down this way. We're still inside the ship, it looks like, in some kind of like corridor. Okay, someone's found us. Here we go. So we were on the outside of the ship when it blew up with Percival. So I don't actually know what happened to Percival. If he made it out or not. I think there's a gap here. To go back a little bit. Oh my god, he's walking slow, isn't he? Can we sprint? Oh, he fell over.
Damn it.
Gotta lose this guy. Just don't touch me, please. I don't want to burn. Oh, shit. I mean, are we going down those stairs or do we need to keep going this way?
Izzy, I'm here. Izzy, can you hear me?
It looks like my microphone might be broken. So yeah, you can hear her. But she can't hear me.
Shit.
Sebastian? Is that Percival? Sebastian. Oh, that's just some random guy, innit? We don't know him. Oh, get moving.
Lucan, Sagramore, Elian. We got contact with Percival and Galahad. I need any able-bodied knight in the vicinity of the Crystal Palace to respond.
It's me.
Gray? Gray, respond. Where the hell are you?
That looks like Percival, right there.
Everyone! Sir Galahad is alive! Fight him!
Why did he put the radio down? He should have said where he was. Wait, am I doing this wrong? Am I not tapping fast enough? Here we go. Percival! Looks like he might be dead. Just give him some potion. That helps anyone. God. He hasn't even tried the potion yet, you know? I mean, Izzy had a broken back from that elder lichen. And the potion worked on her. She was on her feet in like 10 minutes. She had a broken spine. This guy's just a bit tired, I think, isn't he? He shouldn't be in too bad of a condition. Right, so this is a bit later now. Percival must be dead because he's not there. So with the Frenchman, Izzy, and me.
On do this alone. You two head up to the council.
Gray.
It's all right, is he? I'll join you in time for the succession.
Mes pensées sont avec vous, monsieur.
What am I doing alone? Looks like I'm in Tesla's lab.
My condolences. Sir Percival was a great man. The best of us. I took the liberty of keeping these aside. I know it is not standard protocol.
Is that Percival's equipment? Left for me. I don't really know what's going on here. We're just looking at his stuff, like trying to be sad. Kind of rotating this pocket watch. I don't know why. Can we turn it to a certain angle so we can open it? That was a bit pointless.
Grace. Do not blame yourself for what happened. Let this cloud pass.
How can I? He was my mentor. My brother.
So he was. But concern yourself with the upcoming solemnities. The rest can wait.
Too many questions remain, Alistair. I intend to find answers. Mallory's death will be avenged.
Do not fall prey to dark thoughts of retribution. That way madness lies. Come. The council awaits our presence. Lord Hastings is on his way from the United India House. He wishes to thank you in person for saving his life, and the lives of all the other people on the ship. The United India Company owes you a debt of gratitude.
For over six centuries, the Knight's Call Sir Percival sat with us in Brotherhood. He saw entire kingdoms perish, and others equally transitory take their place. He saw the rise of the half-breeds and was relentless in their pursuit. To all these things he bore witness because he was blessed by this. The Grail, the black water that courses through our veins, the bond that unites this order, the elixir which heals all wounds and extends the life of natural men. Yet, it cannot ensure immortality. Now, Sebastian Mallory, once Sir Percival, is dead. There is a tradition of bestowing a knighthood in our order, only on the occasion of the death of him who bears that honor and burden. Generation after generation, new knights have taken the names of their hallowed predecessors. We are assembled here today on just such a solemn occasion. From blood of old. The Grail will give new life. Do you marry Joseph Paul Yves Roch, Gilbert du Motier, Marquis de Lafayette, swear to uphold the most noble precepts of our order? Do you pledge to give your life in service to our righteous cause?
With all my heart and soul.
Drink. May the Grail give you life beyond life. By this communion, you are bound to our sacred order. Henceforth, only your blood shall replenish this vial. May the black water serve you well. Always use it wisely. I dub thee Sir Percival, servant of our great king and knight of the Round Table. Rise, Sir Percival, and assume your rightful place at our table. Guards! Remove Sebastian Mallory's body from the council chamber and take him to the crypt. This council is now called to order. Let the terrible tragedy which has befallen us serve as a warning to those who would defy the mandates of this office. The late Sebastian Mallory did not perish in the fight against the Halfbreeds. No. He died a victim of his own heedless enterprise and the negligence of those sworn to uphold the highest standards of duty and sacrifice. And to what purpose?
Lord Chancellor, I must
have... Public buildings destroyed! Innocent citizens placed at risk. Incalculable damage done to United India Company property. It is only by the mercy of Providence that an even greater disaster was avoided. All this while not a single rebel was taken into custody. On the contrary, by their rogue actions, the knights in question may have done the enemy a great service.
The Lord Chancellor perhaps speaks too harshly. He would do well to remember that Sir Percival's force did uncover evidence of a rebel effort against the...
Circumstantial evidence! Mere supposition, all of which resulted in a deplorable calamity. I will hear no more of the matter.
With respect, Lord Chancellor...
Sit down, Sir Galahad!
With respect! I, too, have lost a friend. More than a friend. A brother. You do great wrong to sully his name in such a manner.
You dance on the very edge of insubordination, Sir Knight.
I am apprehensive of my responsibility in this affair. Yet if the same circumstances should present themselves, I would do exactly as I have done. As Mallory wished.
My lords! Sirs! The rebels have ambushed Lord Hastings' carriage. He and his escort are trapped on the Westminster Bridge.
All knights to arms! Protect Lord Hastings! Let's eliminate these godless rebels once and for all!
Sir Galahad, this matter is not yet over. Someone will yet answer for Sebastian Mallory's death!
Of that you can be sure.
Alright guys, chapter 6 and chapter 7, or maybe 5 and 6. Either way, they're quite short chapters, so I'm just going to put them together into the same video as you guys have probably just seen. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video, which is chapter 8 or 7. I think it's 7. I can't remember. I've lost count. So thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.